This section is on the nutritional influence on chronic disease. And I'd like to start with this quote from Michael Pollan. The Maasai subsist on cattle blood and meat and milk and little else. Native Americans subsist on beans and maize. And the Inuit in Greenland subsist on whale blubber and a little bit of lichen. The irony is, the one diet we have invented for ourselves, the Western diet, is the one that makes us sick. Now, before we move on, I just want to point out the differences in these diets. They're dramatic. Whale blubber and lichen versus beans and maize. But these are ancestral diets. These are diets. And these, of what we used to follow, depending on where we lived and who our ancestors were. Now, these cultures, these populations, did not have heart disease, diabetes, cancer. So it's important for us to look back at the history, some of the diets that existed prior to the last 100 years, or even 10,000 years, and think about the differences between those diets and our diet today, and how our diet impacts us. So what is the Western diet? This is typically the diet of the Western nations, developed countries, started by the only United States, of course, but is now spread throughout the world. And look at what this blue area of the pie represents right here. Vegetables, fruit, whole grains, and legumes. Right here in red, some red meat, poultry, eggs, milk, and cheese. Okay, so whole foods. Now, what about over here? The majority of the diet, processed and refined foods. Oils, fats, processed fats, fast foods, and sweets. The Western diet is what we call the standard American diet. And it's sad. It is sad. SAD, standard American diet. Because we're not getting enough of the foods that we need, and we're getting too many of the foods that we don't need. So when you think about the standard American diet, I do want you to think how sad it is that we're creating a diet, or we have created a diet, that has created chronic disease. All right, so healthy. What is healthy? Well, again, there are different diets, and different people advocate for different things, but we have some general rules about a healthy diet and lifestyle. Whole vegetables. Whole fruits, so not processed, whole fruits. Whole grains. Now, if you're someone who's eating a paleo diet, you're not going to include grains. That's okay. But if you are eating grains, make sure they are whole grains. They're not ground and processed and reformulated. Good fats, and we'll learn about good fats, which fats are good and which fats you want to minimize. Moderate calorie intake, getting adequate physical activity, limiting processed fats. And so there's some argument, there'll be debate on which fats are good and which ones aren't. We want to eat fats. Fats are extremely important to our diet. Processed fats are not good. You should avoid processed fats, trans fat at all costs. Processed meats. Deli meats, cured meats. Really, you want to limit these types of meats. If you're eating meat, let's say you're not vegan and you're eating meat, then you want to make sure it's a whole cut of meat. That meat should look like a muscle, a whole meat, not processed. Limit refined grains. So this is the opposite of our whole grains. If you are choosing to eat grains, you don't want a grain that doesn't look like a grain. I mean, if it's ground and processed and reformulated, then you've lost most of the health benefit. Limit alcohol intake, just avoid tobacco, and avoid food additives as much as possible. We'll get into this towards the very end of the class. So I keep referring to chronic disease, and you're probably thinking, well, what is chronic disease? You know, I don't even know what that is. Well, it's something that slowly develops over time. It really takes a long time, decades, for these types of diseases to develop. And it lacks any quick cure. You don't develop diabetes and then take a pill and have it cured. You might take a pill to manage diabetes. It's not going to cure it. Same with heart disease. cancer as well. And yes, nutrition definitely has an influence on cancer as well as your other lifestyle choices. So these take years to develop. When we think about the leading causes of death in the United States, we want to look at which ones we have control over. What impact can I have on my own cause of death? Well, there are things we can't control, right? So let's look at this list. Down at the very bottom, we see heart disease. And heart disease are leading cause of death followed by cancer. Then we have chronic lung disease, definitely impacted from smoking, but that's not nutrition, although it is lifestyle. Then stroke and then diabetes. So these are all impacted from nutrition. It's not only nutrition, but nutrition has an impact on these diseases. A few hundred years ago, these weren't the leading causes of death. And definitely 10,000 years ago, they were not the leading causes of death. So our lifestyle, what you put into your body, is contributing to your health and eventual potential cause of death. It's not as if you can prevent all of these from being healthy, but you can definitely decrease your risk. So who wants disease? I don't think anybody wants disease. Do you want heart disease? Do you want to be huffing and puffing going up the stairs? Do you want to not be able to do the things you enjoy doing? Do you want to make a trip to the doctor every week, pop 10 pills a day? I don't think anyone wants that. No one wants diabetes. They don't want to lose the sensation in their feet, develop ulcers, have their kidneys shut down, lose their vision. And of course, no one wants cancer. The reason I put this up here is I always have students say, well, you know, I'm 25 and I'm healthy. I don't have any health problems. I feel good. You know, I don't need to change my diet. But what you do today is going to impact you down the road. These things take time. And over time, what you put into your body is going to make a difference in the long run. And I know it's hard to look two decades down the road, but it's important to make those choices. And in addition, a lot of your healthy choices will impact you now and how you're feeling, your energy levels. And some people do get diseases even in their early 30s. So what contributes to chronic disease? Well, there's certainly genetics. And as my friend once said, you can't swim out of your gene pool. I mean, if you have certain genetics, you're stuck with those genetics, but you can have an impact on those genetics. Just because you have a diabetes in your family does not mean you're going to get diabetes. What you put into your body impacts those genes. And we'll discuss this later when we get to our chapter on health and nutrition. Viral infections can contribute to chronic disease. Lifestyle choices, such as drinking alcohol, smoking cigarettes, leading a sedentary lifestyle. Environmental factors, if you're going to live in a place that has more smog, you're going to have a greater chance of having more oxidation, more carcinogens in your life, potentially a greater chance of developing lung cancer. Poor nutrition, physical inactivity, socioeconomic class. Poor people have a greater chance of developing chronic disease. You wouldn't think this would impact it, but some people living in urban areas don't even have access to fresh fruits and vegetables. Low birth weight, certainly not something you can control. As we age, the more you age, and hopefully you all will live a long life, but the older you are, the greater chance of chronic disease. And you can't ignore stress. Now we're going to focus on lifestyle, physical inactivity, and of course, nutrition.